Forza Horizon 4 has been out for more than 2 years now. With Forza Horizon 5 probably being not so far away, this might be a good time to do a little recap on Horizon 4. Many people have already made videos about Forza Horizon 4 and 5, which are most often not usable as feedback for the developers to gather information. In a nutshell, they are trash. With this video, I want to create something for Playground Games to use as feedback, based on the opinions of multiple experienced players. While the chance that Playground Games see this video is slim, in my opinion it is worth the effort, if there is a chance that they will see it. I know that Playground Games listen to their community, which they recently showed with the Super 7 update. If Playground Games and the community, especially the core community of the Horizon series, work together for Forza Horizon 5, we could possibly create the best open world racing game of all time. I'll start with a short explanation about the data I collected and what this video contains. Then we will move on to talk about the positive aspects of the game. There I will just include the positives without talking about what's missing, because I will include those things later in the video. Then we will talk about the negative aspects of the game and other things that sometimes prevent a good gaming experience. After this we will go through a list of things missing in Horizon 4 to maybe be added in Horizon 5, as well as some map characteristics we want to see in Horizon 5. Finally, there is a conclusion. In this video I won't go too much into detail because it would end up being way too long. I will present the argument and briefly explain. I asked many very experienced players to share their opinions to make this representative. In the description you can find the players with their playtime for Horizon 4, as well as the Discords involved, so you can see for yourself. You can find a small bar at the top right corner of this video while I'm talking about a point. The percentage number tells you what percentage of those who voted agreed to that point. Underneath you can find the exact number of votes out of the number of voting people in the category. This video does not contain wishes for cars and specific locations for Forza Horizon 5, as well as problems with the community and bans. If you want to add your opinion to this video, or if you want to add something on the list, there's a poll you can find in the description. The poll is anonymous and you can see what other people's voted for after completing it. But please read the instructions on the top of the poll, because if you don't, the whole poll could be useless. Just a disclaimer before we move on. All the negative things I will mention in this video should serve as a basis of criticism for Forza Horizon 5, not to be used to change Forza Horizon 4 anymore, because it's just way too much effort to fix all the things in Horizon 4. The data gathering was done before Super 7 was released, so it won't be included as an argument itself. A big thank you to Playground Games to include such a big update, even though the game is quite old. And now, let's get started. Let's talk about the positives first, the strength of the game and what makes Forza Horizon 4 so great. The first thing to mention here are the graphics of the game. Forza Horizon 4 just looks astonishing. There are so many details you can find in the world, but also the cars are very detailed, especially the cars that are new to the Forza series. Also, the number and variety of cars is very amazing. From your daily driver to the fastest cars in the world, and from track toys to absolute cross-country machines. There's a car for everyone in this game, with more than 730 cars available, all of them in high quality. The handling and the physics of the game are very good. They feel good and are a good balance of realism and arcade. Also, the possibility to choose between normal and sim steering gives the player a good opportunity to adapt the game more to himself, with normal steering being a bit more easy to drive and sim steering being a bit more realistic but being a bit harder to handle. The implementation of seasons brought much variety to the world of Horizon 4. Every season has its own characteristics and adds new options. There are different things to explore in each season, like driving across the lake in winter and driving through wonderful flower fields in spring. The different weather effects add to this. They look very good and have a great level of detail. It has a small but quite realistic impact on the handling as well. The long support run of Forza Horizon 4 is just incredible. The game is more than 2 years old and we just got a huge update with the Super 7 update. Horizon 3, for example, had the latest update with content nearly a year after its release. We also get a new car nearly every week for free. Over the lifespan of Forza Horizon 4, we got about 200 cars for free. That's more than most racing games even offer in total. The crossplay also works quite well. There's no difference between playing on PC, Xbox One or Series X or S, except for being Xbox at the finish line. Great Britain is very well represented in Fossil Island 4. There are different biomes you can find in real life as well, forests, a lake, plains, hills, rivers, a beach and so on. Also objects like the wind farms, the wheat fields, the dam, the quarry etc. are a good addition, as well as the plentiful supply of real life landmarks. The translation between the biomes are also very good. They don't feel unnatural while playing and create some cool looking spots as well. The photo mode allows for some cool shots and has quite a few options. It also can be used for creating cinematics because of its good controls. The track editor works fine and allows for some cool tracks. It allows us to create races on roads which are not used by the game. The design editor works really well and offers a good selection of colors. It's easy to reuse and works great for most of the time. It also runs very fluid and you have much freedom doing whatever you want with many usable pre-made vinyls to add onto the car and the ability to create countless custom patterns and logos. The game has a really good performance. The game runs really fluid and the loading times on a good PC or the Series X are very short, although it can be a pain on older consoles. Forza Horizon 4 offers a lot of freedom. You can do nearly everything you want. The map has few unbreakable boundaries and you can explore many things in the game. The game very often doesn't limit you in what you're doing. With the Super 7 update, we got even more options to mess around and create awesome things. Nearly every car can be modified. Most of them have basic tuning possibilities, while some have some more visual options. You can make your car everything you want to. You want a hypercar for rallying? Just do it. You want your Ray Daily driver to beat everything on the quarter mile? Just do it. You want your Cadillac limo to be a drift machine? You get it. The game offers a huge amount of content. Not only a big selection of cars, but also all the other things I've listed and even some more things. The amount of content still increases most recently with this Super 7 update. The DLCs of this game are really good, in no way inferior to those of Horizon 3. Even though many dislike the LEGO DLC, often without even trying it out, the quality of both DLCs is very good with much room and both bringing new features, cars and variety to the game. Playground Games also gave us many things we requested in those DLCs. We got serpentines on cliffs on Fortune Island and we've got a racetrack and a stunt park on LEGO Rally. Forza Horizon 4 offers a lot of variety to the game as well, with many different game modes, cars and options. For nearly every type of player there's something to do. From cruising through the landscapes to driving the fastest hypercars, from going completely wild in cross-country runs to fighting wheel-to-wheel with other players and from painting your car to building your own tracks. Nobody goes away empty-handed by buying this game. There's even a Battle Royale mode available, so... In terms of price-performance ratio, Forza Horizon 4 leaves almost everything behind. Even if you just buy the standard edition, you have many things to explore, collect and achieve. You can play the game for even less money by buying the Game Pass. 70 € for the basic game isn't cheap, but you can easily spend hundreds if not thousands of hours in this game just to complete everything. The character customization offers a good selection of characters and clothing and is a nice feature to personalize your character. It also lets you create some ridiculous looking characters and there are some nice things to collect. Forza Horizon 4 has a huge demo to test the game out. In fact, the demo is even bigger than many other full modern games, containing more than 26 GB. For a game with a minimum price of 70 €, if you ignore the Game Pass for a second, this is very cool to make sure if you want to spend the money on the game or not. Now after going through the positives, let's move on to the negatives. Those are things that really need to change in the next Horizon title because sometimes they can destroy the gaming experience. The AI is just a complete disaster in this game. They most often choose the same 3 cars and they just don't work properly. In single player they aren't competitive, even on unbeatable, and they don't fight with the player or other AIs. They are just following the racing line and won't get off it, except when they go way too fast into a corner, which happens quite often. You also can push them even if your car weighs more. In co-op it's even worse. They are just lagging around, stop randomly on the track, crash you off the track and do really stupid maneuvers. They can't be pushed here either, with the addition of being able to push you as much as they want to. The servers used for Horizon 4 are prone to crash. Sometimes it even takes several tries just to join a seasonal event with a convoy and then the server crashes on the last race. Desync, especially to Xbox One players, is also prominent and really annoying sometimes. It's not that bad most of the time and it allows for reel-to-reel racing with other players, but sometimes I cross over in front of my opponent without even touching him on my screen, but I push him off the track on his screen. The car sounds in this game aren't very good. Some cars are too loud, like the M4, some are rated silent and some are completely silent at the back but loud at the front. For example, most of the Lancer Evos. The sounds aren't very good themselves either. Some are alright, but some of them just aren't. An RX-7 should sound like this. And not like this. PI balance and meta cars are a genuine problem in the game, especially in A-class. In many classes you often just have a few competitive cars to choose from. S2 and S1 have this issue less, but especially in A-class and B-class you typically have just 2 or 3 cars available if you want to become a Grandmaster. It's nearly impossible to create a well-balanced system for over 700 cars, but cars like the Hula Girl or the Atomic Punk really destroy the competition. Forza Horizon 4's ranking system is complete trash, especially in solo adventures. The OP cars and ramming players make it even worse. You can lose ranking points if you win every race in the adventure just because you get in a lobby with the low ranks. And you can't use more normal cars in the adventure to get a high rank because you will get beaten by those mentioned OP cars and you would destroy your ranking. Then there's also the problem with rammers who destroy your ranking by pushing off the track etc. In team adventures you can abuse the matchmaking with low rank or no rank second accounts to boost another account up to Grandmaster with friends, which is really unfair to other players. The intro sound is too loud. The game has some weird collisions. Sometimes you get stuck touching a flat wall or you get launched into the air. Also, the collisions with properties are very strange sometimes. They lift your car in the air or push you off the track. The problem is that properties like bushes, street poles or steel fences are quite big and do not compress or disintegrate into multiple small parts, so they push the player away when stuck between a car or on the wall. The design editor is very good in this game, but it suffers from bad vinyl resolution. Small details and extras most often end up being completely blurred. Also, there's a lack of precision because of this. This can ruin the look of a livery, especially painful with the high effort many creators put into their work. The streets in Horizon 4 are just way too big. In Horizon 3 they were already really wide, but Horizon 4s are even wider. You can easily fit 2 or even 3 cars on one lane, on most of the roads, which is just way too much. Of course it allows for more space in races, but it just feels unnatural and is one of the reasons of the slow feeling of speed in the game. There are only a few tight roads, which are very cool indeed, but just far too few. Many people also bring up the lack of story, which is understandable considering there is no story. But this point is far too detailed to be able to discuss it here, which is why I refer to Jake MC's video on this topic. He made a really good job keeping it constructive and illuminated both sides, so go check it out if you want to see more about this topic. Forza Horizon 4 is not compatible with in-game capture. This can be really annoying sometimes, so this should be fixed in the next game. Save games corrupt quite often in this game and it's really annoying. Having your whole progression reset is probably the most frustrating thing that can happen in a game like this. I know a few people myself who had the problem, for example Stone Officer who got all his stuff back, except for level liveries and tunings, but he had to complete everything again he completed. At least the support is good to get back most of your stuff, but this shouldn't happen in the future Horizon titles. Free Roam Rush offers experienced players a good chance of gathering points in ranked adventures because they usually know the map very well, which is cool, but it also makes the whole championship very dependent on the car and is very often very frustrating. It demotivates you to drive the championship at all. In Horizon 4 there's no progression. Horizon 3 already had nearly no progression, with only the festival upgrades serving as a progression system, but in Horizon 4 there isn't even this. The only progression you have is unlocking new races. It's way better on the LEGO DLC, where you can unlock new parts for your house by completing the mission, but still this isn't enough and shouldn't be counted as LEGO is an optional DLC. Originally, this point was about the censorship of designs in this game, but I think this whole topic is way too complicated. This topic is mostly about the Rising Sun, and while I can understand designers who want to use it for their liveries, I can also understand Playground Games for having it on the ban list. If you want to know what is allowed and what is not, watch this Forza Monthly stream. There's also a link with the timestamp in the description. For those who don't know why the Rising Sun is a bannable symbol, I'll try to explain it. Basically, the Rising Sun in South and East Asia is similar to SS rooms and the swastika in Europe and America. Here in Germany it is against the law to show those symbols, except for an educational purpose, etc. So please keep that in mind when talking about this topic. Now that we've got through the positives and negatives of Horizon 4, let's talk about the things that should be added in Horizon 5. One of the things that definitely should improve is tuning. I will go back a little further here because there are many things to talk about. Let's talk about the nonsense in the current tuning first, then about the missing performance tuning options, and at last about the missing visual and aero tuning. There are some huge bugs in the current tuning, especially the aerodynamics really make no sense sometimes. I mean, how can the Forza Wing produce more downforce on the skyline than the West Wing? Most of the non-Forza aerodynamics have literally no effect on the aerodynamics of the car, and can't even be set up. This makes you really limited if you want to create a good tune for a class or if you're like me and create homologation classes. I personally don't have a problem with the Forza Wing, but I want to be able to use the other available wings, which are very cool sometimes as well, or even multiple Forza Wings. Also, the brake balance tuning is still inverted and should be fixed. What would also be nice to see would be slick tires, which we sadly don't have on every car. In terms of performance tuning, there should be an option to set up turbo timings, which would give us the opportunity to build up register charging these turbo systems or simply boosting up the engine even more. Visuals are something we could speak about for hours, so I'll make it short. More body kits, more spoilers, more wings, canards, diffusers, more bumpers and skirts, mirrors, vortexes, head and tail lights, more rims, brake calipers, customizable tire walls, air ride suspension, and a customizable cockpit. I know there are many things listed and those are way too many to include on every car, even for the next Horizon title. So I would suggest starting out with like 10 cars with many, maybe even licensed tuning options. Let's take those 10 for example. They get the enumerated tuning options. Then after a while you add those tuning options to 10 more cars which could already be in the game. Then 10 more again and again and again. Nobody can expect that every car instantly has all of those tuning options, so you just take it step by step. Adding tuning to cars which are already in the game could also lead to older cars being used more often because they would be interesting again. Adding placeable objects in the track editor would offer a lot of possibilities for people who want to create racing tracks, gymkhanas or else. It would also be useful for competitive racing like in Horizon Team Wars. We should be able to set the start of the race anywhere we want as well. Also, the creation of the track and setting up the racing line should be separated, because if you create the racing line after the route driven while creating, it is most often way slower than the intended racing line. Bring back private lobbies. Sometimes random players can be really annoying in public lobbies, especially if you want to record a video or if you want to make shots for a cinematic, etc. More different options for races would be very cool. New racing modes like Time Attack or Time Trial in multiplayer lobby, multi-class racing, head-to-head tournament racing, etc. Also, an option to determine how many drivers there should be in a race and to determine the starting grid position of the drivers by the host, at least in PvP, would be great. Also, a hopper system would be a nice addition like one used in Forza Motorsport 7. We need a cinematic editor. Forza Horizon offers big opportunities to create cinematics, car pawns or even short movies with its graphics, cars, world and so on. But you just have no options to record properly. We need something like in GTA 5 where you can record the game while playing and edit the scene afterwards with many different camera options, etc. Or just give us the editor Playground Games uses for their trailers and videos. It is a waste with a game which has incredible graphics and map design. In addition to the cinematic editor, we should be able to save and watch replays of races, especially from PvP and PvE races. Furthermore, spectator mode would be cool, so players can join races as spectators, which would be especially cool for tournaments and championships, as well as for adventures, so you don't have to sit randomly driving your car 3 minutes whilst a race takes place. Bringing back Goof Music or adding the option of connecting Spotify to the game would be nice. Although the music in Horizon is quite okay, it gets really boring after time, and the variety just isn't there. Although this is understandable as it's a racing game after all. Therefore, being able to add your own music would make it the in-game radio more attractive again. Also, a return of Future Classic, Vagrant Records and Epitaph Records or a new radio station like Hopeless Records would be very cool. The racetracks from the game itself in Horizon 4 are quite okay, but not often really exciting. You've got tracks like Princess Street Gardens and Greendale Club Circuit, which are very cool, but on the other end you have Derwent Reservoir and the Meadows, which are boring, repetitive and without any unique character. Many tracks are very identical to one another or even the same, but just shorter. In Horizon 4 there are many roads not used by the game, which definitely should be used, especially in the dirt racing series. The design editor could need new options as well. Vinyls should have the full texture options like the car's base paint and not only the base colors. Furthermore, there are sometimes a few problems if you have to extend the vinyl like a logo or something from a side to the car to the top of the car, etc. We are also waiting for the option of adding decals to the windows of our cars. An option to sort cars in the garage by custom groups would be very helpful. For example, creating a GT3 group for all of my cars with my GT3 tunings, etc. We've got so many cars in this game and will probably increase in Horizon 5 like it did in any Horizon title compared to its predecessor, so this would come in handy. It would be cool to see to have the Forza Vista options in the open world, like opening and closing doors, trunks and hoods, or to open the top of convertibles while standing or slow rolling, as well as turning the engine off while standing still. Also, turning lights on and off while driving would be a nice option. We have custom team championships but no custom solo championships, but solo championships would often be more useful. More cars per race would be nice to see. An increase up to 18 or more would be cool. Same for the number of players in a convoy. The photo mode is pretty good, but it could need some more options as well. The camera height limit should increase by a lot, same for the drone by the way. Also an option to unfreeze the game in photo mode, at least if your car stands still, would be cool to see. Another often mentioned wish was to include the bucket lists again, but with the inclusion of Super 7, this point is over. Anna is extremely useless in Horizon 4. The only option you could ever need is disabling and enabling head-to-head races, which you can also do in the pause menu. To make Anna useful, you should be able to set routes to other players or specific locations or something like this. This could even be paired with the Forza Vista and Open World, where you could open doors or turn on the lights with Anna. Being able to drive the tracks in reverse would really add some variation to the races without drastic map redesign. One thing missing in Horizon 4 are long straights. There's no big airfield and no long straight highway. Horizon 4 has some great dirt sections, for example the trail on the west side of Derwent Water or this narrow dirt track near the Phalon Manor. Those are great, but they are either too short or they end in a normal street without opportunities of continuing to drive on dirt tracks or both. Furthermore, there's a lack of narrow and challenging trails with certain length. A racetrack on the mainland would be nice, maybe even a licensed one depending on the location of Horizon 5. If the setting is Japan for example, you could throw in Suzuka. If it's America, you could give us Daytona or Laguna Seca. All of these tracks are already in Motorsport 7. The return of multiple festivals of the map would also be welcome, maybe in a form of a mix of Horizon 3 and 4, with one big festival with a racetrack and multiple small ones distributed on the map. Longer and more serpentines would be very welcomed. We have some small ones on the mainland and a long serpentine one on Fortune Island, but they are either too short or too wide. The one on Fortune Island is cool, but it's extremely wide. Narrower serpentines would also offer a cool challenge for driving or drifting. Steep dedicated hill climbs would also be fun. A big bridge would be very cool to see. The mile-long drag strips or an AR field just need to be in the Next Horizon title. With cars driving up to 480 if not 500 kph in the game, we need a place to drive those speeds, especially without slipstream. The highway in Forza Horizon 4 really is too short and has too much elevation and has turns in it, which makes it nearly impossible to get up to speed or do long drag races. The map of Horizon 4 has many elevation changes and really cool ones as well, but maybe some steeper roads and bumpier narrow paths would be cool to see as well. There are so many cars that just never get used, mainly the extreme off-roaders. Some slow-paced off-road or rally raid routes would add some welcome variety and also give the extreme off-road class some use. Forza Horizon 4 is one of the greatest games we've got in the last couple of years, and it is definitely a step up from Forza Horizon 3. There are some weak points as well, especially in terms of competitive racing and single-player content. Maybe Horizon 5 could be based on the characteristics of Horizon 4, but with the story and the general vibe of Horizon 1 and 2. Nevertheless, Forza Horizon 4 is a great game and is in no way inferior to the other Horizon games. Just a short message to Playgon Games to close this whole thing. I think everyone who took part of this video wants to help you build up Forza Horizon 5, because we want a game even better than Horizon 4. We want an open conversation between the developers and the experienced players, and I'm pretty sure you want that too, because you have shown this multiple times in the past. That's it for this video, I really hope you enjoyed it, and if somebody from Playground Games should have watched this to the end, a big thank you for listening to us. This video was a lot of work, I'm talking about hundreds of hours of work in this video, so I would really appreciate it if you leave a like. It would also be very cool if you could share this video. Also, a big thank you to other people who helped me out creating this video. See you next time, bye.